Good morning, students. So the previous video we were discussing about the torque on a current loop, but we couldn't be able to complete due to the data that got over. Okay, so let me explain once again the torque experienced by a current loop. Okay. So let us study about the torque experienced by a current loop. Here, two magnets are placed. Try to observe the diagram. This is the north pole of the magnet. Here, let me take this is the south pole of the magnet. We are going to keep the loop. The loop named as P, Q, R and S. So P, Q, R, S is the loop. Okay. So here the magnetic field lines will be start from the north pole to south pole, so it will be moving in the plane of the bolt as a horizontal line along the positive x axis. And let us assume that the current flowing through the circuit in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so let me take L is the length of the current carrying conductor. And B is the width. Let me denote the length and the breadth here. Let us assume that the L, this is the L, okay? Yeah. L means this length, okay? The L is the length of the current carrying conductor and this is B. B is the breadth of the current carrying conductor. And I is the strength of the current flowing through the conductor in the anti-clockwise direction. At this point, there is a magnetic field that is acting in the positive x-axis. At the midpoint here, the magnetic field will be acting here. In this direction, the magnetic field will be acting here. And here also, the magnetic field will be acting in that direction. Now, according to the Fleming's left-hand rule, the force segment, we can able to find out the force. So, keep the thumb, forefinger and the middle finger mutually perpendicular to each other. The thumb indicates the direction of the force FB, magnetic field, and the central finger indicates the direction of the current. Okay. So, let us use one of the right hand, left hand thumb rule to find the force. So, here the field is along the positive x-axis. So, it is along the positive x-axis. And the current is towards downward direction. So let me take the current. So the force will be acting towards U. Correct? No, the force will be acting towards this direction. That means here the force will be acting towards this. That force, let me take it as F. The dot indicates that the force is acting in the upward, perpendicular to the plane of the paper. Okay. But here the current direction alone changes. So this force will be acting in the downward direction. That force will be acting in the downward direction. Now, let me take here. Here, n is the normal vector and this angle, let me take it as theta. Theta is the angle between the normal and the magnetic field. That let me take it as theta. Okay. So, here also a force will be acting. That force we can able to find out by using again Fleming's left hand rule. Here, the magnetic field along the positive x-axis, the current is moving moving through this direction, moving from towards here, then the force will be acting in the downward direction. See here, here the current is, magnetic field is here, the current is moving that side, so the force will be acting towards downward. So this force you can take it as F 3. This you take it as F2, this is F1, and here the direction of the current changes. So this force will be acting in the upper direction, that you take it as F4. Here the F3 and the F4 are in the same line of action, that is very, very important. Both are in the same line of action. But this F1 and F2 are acting in the opposite direction, but not in the same line of action. Hence, they produce a torque. But these two forces, F3 and F4, they cancel each other, and the net effect on the given current loop will be zero. For example, here let us find out the we need to find out the angle between the magnetic field and the current carrying conductor, because we know the formula. So this angle you can take it as 90 minus theta. Here this is 90 minus theta. When you are taking here, this will be the angle. Here also the normal will be acting here. This angle you can take it as theta. So this angle will be 90 plus theta. That is very, very important. The angle between the current and the magnetic field is 90 plus theta. Here the angle will be 90 minus theta. Okay. So first let us find out the force F3. F3 is equal to BIL sin theta, but here the length will be equal to the breadth. So BIB sin 90 minus theta, that is equal to BID cos theta. Okay. So next let us find out F4. F4. The angle will be BIB sin 90 plus theta. Sin 90 plus theta is equal to minus cos theta. So you will be getting minus BIB cos theta. This you take it as equation 1. This you take it as equation 2. Here both the forces are having equal magnitude, but they are acting in the opposite direction. So they get cancel each other. The net force acting on the given thing will be equal to 0. So net force will be equal to 0. So we got F3 and we got F4. Now let us enter F3 we got, F4 we got. Now let us go for F1 and F2. Find out F1. F1 we know the formula BI, here the length L, and the angle will be 90. So sin 90, that is equal to BIL. But here it will be acting in the upward direction, that is represented by the dot. And F2 is equal to, again, BIL sin 90, that is equal to BIL, but here it will be acting into, both are not acting in the same line of action, but F3 and F4 are in the same line of action, hence they cancel each other. But F1 and F2 are not acting in the different, not acting in the same line of action. They are acting in the different line of action, hence they constitute a torque. Okay, so the torque can be obtained by the formula tau is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Okay, force into perpendicular distance. Okay, how do you find out the perpendicular distance? That is very important. Let me take this as B. Okay, this is B. Here two forces are acting. One force will be acting in the upward direction, that is F1. Acting in the dot, correct now? And another force will be acting in the downward direction, that will be taken as F2, that is acting into the plane. But both are not acting in the same line of action. So we need to find out the perpendicular distance. We need to find out the perpendicular distance. Here, at this point, the normal will be acting here. The magnetic field B will be acting here. It makes an angle theta. Okay, that makes an angle theta. So this angle is theta, means what about this angle? This also theta. That means the B makes an angle theta with the vertical axis. That means y axis. B makes an angle theta with the vertical axis. So this component, the vertical component, can be written as B cos theta. Right? Carefully what is that? This can be written as B cos theta. And this component, the horizontal component, will be equal to B sin theta. That will be equal to B sin theta. So that is the distance between the two forces. So now let us find out the torque. Tau is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Let us use the formula force. You can take any one force, that is nothing but BIL into the perpendicular distance can be written as B into sin theta. But you know that length into breadth is equal to area. Yes. So the length and the breadth can be taken as area. So this can be written as BIA into sin theta. Okay, now BIA into sin theta. Now, this is for only one tons. For n tons, let us take this for what are n tons. Then tau can be written as I n b a into sin theta. Don't forget. So simply keep in mind this formula can be written as inba sin theta. Don't forget. Can be written as what are inba sin theta. I n b a sin theta. I is the current flowing through the conductor. N is the number of turns in the given coil. B is the magnetic strength or magnetic field strength. A is the area. Theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the current carrying conductor. Okay. So that about the torque. So torque is equal to INBA sin theta. Okay. But here one more thing also we have to keep in mind. The magnetic moment. What is mean by magnetic moment? See here. What is mean by magnetic moment? Magnetic moment denoted by the letter M. Magnetic moment is equal to I into A. The product of current and area, that can be called as a magnetic moment. So the unit will be ampere meter square. This is for only one term. Suppose for n terms, M can be written as N into I into A. Don't forget. M can be written as N into I into A. So now, let us come back here. Now you know the torque is equal to INBA. Here INA can be written as the magnetic moment M. So you can write tau is equal to MB into sin theta. In vector form, it can be written as tau vector is equal to M vector cross B vector. Okay, tau is equal to M vector cross B vector, where M is the magnetic moment and B is the magnetic field. Okay, in electrostatics, the same formula we have learnt it for a electric field. The electric field also can produce a torque, but that torque will be equal to, for electrostatics, the formula will be tau is equal to P vector cross what not a E vector. Here P is the dipole moment, electric dipole moment, but here M is the magnetic dipole moment, E is the electric field, but here B is the magnetic field. That is the difference between the two things. Understood, Nada? These are about the torque experienced by a current flow. Okay, normally in school they may confuse you, okay, while taking the direction and while taking theta, you have to be very careful. Okay, while taking the formula of force, we need the angle. That angle is nothing but the angle between the magnetic field and the current carrying conductor or the current element IV. Okay. So that only we can take it as 90 minus theta. But when you are taking F4, it is 90 plus theta. But F1 and F2, the angle will be perpendicular, so 90. Okay. But these two are acting in the same line of action, so they cancel each other. But F1 and F2 never be cancelled. So we have to take what that means. If they are not acting in the same line of action, they will constitute a torque. The torque only obtained by using the formula force into perpendicular distance. To find the perpendicular distance, we have taken here. This is the normal and this is the magnetic field B. This angle is theta. And you know that this will be almost 90 degree. Understood or not? So this angle is 90 degree means what about this angle? This will be 90 minus theta. Then this angle also can be taken as a 90 minus theta. Then this will be theta. Understood how we got theta? See here, This is theta, this is 90, so this will be 90 minus theta, because again this is perpendicular, this angle. Okay, 90 minus theta means this also will be 90 minus theta. So if this is 90 minus theta, then this will be theta. So B makes an angle theta with the vertical. So this common will be B cos theta. And this will be wire, which axis it makes, that will be the cos component. And the perpendicular will be sine. So we need to get the perpendicular distance, that we have to take it as B sine theta. Substitute over there, you will be getting the torque. Now let us move on to the application of this torque. So you can ask, sir, what is the important application of this torque? The important application of torque is nothing but galvanometer. You will be doing the experiment in the lab. There you will be using what, the galvanometer. Now we are going to study about the uses of the construction and the uses of galvanometer. The main principle of the galvanometer is nothing but the torque experienced by the current flow. Okay, that is the main principle of the galvanometer. Okay, so now we are going to study about what are the moving coil galvanometer. Let us go to the The main important application of the torque experience by a current loop is what? A moving coil galvanometer, MCG. Don't forget, it can be called as a moving coil galvanometer, MCG. The principle is nothing but the current carrying loop placed in a uniform magnetic field experiences a torque. Okay, that is the principle of the moving coil galvanometer. In the moving coil galvanometer, you see the construction, let us see, it has a radial magnetic field, like what, not a horseshoe magnet, okay. This is the north pole, you say, this is the south pole. Understand? This is the magnetic field will be perpendicular. So all the points, let's take this as what, not a, the midpoint of this thing. All the field will be passes through what, not this way. North to south here, and this is also north to south. All the place, the angle theta will be 90 degree. That means the formula, we know that torque tau is equal to inbar sine theta. The theta can be replaced now, because all the place the theta will be 90 means sine 90 value will be 1. There is no use of using theta in the given formula. Okay, for that case only we are using what, not the radial magnetic field. Okay, the radial magnetic field will provide a uniform magnetic field. It will provide what, not a uniform magnetic field. Okay, that is the main important application of radial magnetic field. Actually, if you see the diagram, it has what, on the two terminals. This you can take it as T1 and this you can take it as T2. The terminal T1 has a loop. Okay. The loop is made by, or a spiral loop. It is made by phosphor bronze. Don't forget, it is made by what, not a phosphor bronze. The end of the loop, we have what, not a small coil. The coil will be wound on a non-metallic material, and the other end will be taken and it is connected to another T2. That means these are the two terminals you can find in the ammeter or voltmeter. You can find two terminals. One is positive and another one is negative. One is represented by red color and another one is represented by black color. Similarly here, but this is made by what, not a phosphor bronze. Why we are using phosphor bronze, let me explain later. The first thing, the phosphor bronze will act as a current carrying conductor, and it has high tensile strength. It has to bear the weight of the coil. The coil only plays here, correct? No, it has to bear the weight of the coil. So we are using that phosphor bronze material. It has very high tensile strength, and here only the pointer will be connected. The pointer will be attached here. Okay, this side only the magnetic needle, sorry, the horseshoe magnetic or radial magnetic field will be there. The radial magnetic field will produce a uniform magnetic field. The coil is placed in a uniform magnetic field, and you know that the coil now experiences a torque, so the pointer will move on the scale. Here you can able to find the scale. Here the readings will be marked, so you can able to find out the reflection. Based on the reflection, we can able to calculate the current which is flowing through the galvanometer. The galvanometer is a device which can use to measure the small current which normally cannot be measured by using an ammeter. At the same time, we can able to find out the direction of the flow of current also by using one of the moving coil galvanometer. That cannot be obtained by using ammeter. That is the main difference between what an ammeter and a galvanometer. Galvanometer is more sensitive than the ammeter. The current which cannot be able to measured by the ammeter can be able to measure by using one of the galvanometer. Even the current in the order less than milliampere also can be measured by using galvanometer. Okay, so this coil, okay, the coil is suspended at the one end of the torsional spring. If we see the spring, it will look like what order? That is represented here. This is the spring. This is the terminal what not T1. It is look like a spiral. And here only you can able to find out what not the coil. The other terminal taken here T2. This diagram only given your textbook. Okay, this diagram I have given you to what not know the working of the galvanometer. Now here the pointer will be attached, and here you can able to find out what not the scale. This will be the scale. Under the scale, here you can able to find out what not a small mirror. You can ask, sir, what is the use of this mirror? So the mirror or not to avoid parallax error. Okay, so the image of the pointer will be found on the mirror. While taking the reading, you have to keep your eye such a way that the pointer should coincide with the image of the pointer. That time the parallax error will be neglected, or that will be equal to zero. So to avoid the parallax error, a small mirror will be given. These questions can be asked as a viva question in your practical. Why the mirror is given here? Okay, not only in galvanometer, you can even find the mirror in ammeter as well as voltmeter. Okay, so now actually what is the real principle of the given thing? You see that when we give a current flowing through the given coil, the coil is placed in a uniform magnetic field produced by the radial magnetic field, so automatically it will experience a torque. So when it experiences a torque, the pointer starts rotate. Okay, the pointer starts rotate. They just imagine that it is a spring. The spring is connected here. The other end only the coil. When current flowing through the coil starts rotating in this direction. When the coil start rotating in this direction, automatically the spring gets tightened. Correct, na? The spring gets tightened. So when the spring gets tightened, a restoring torque will be developed on the spring. It is equivalent to pressing the spring. If you press the spring, what will happen? Automatically a force will be, restoring force will be developed over there. If you leave it, the spring gets jumped. Correct, na? Similar way, when the coil starts rotating, the spring gets tightened. When the spring gets tightened, automatically a force restoring torque will be developed on the spring. Okay, at equilibrium means what? We are sending the current. Based on the current, there is a torque created. At equilibrium, what will happen? Both the torque, that means the torque developed by the coil will be equal to the restoring torque developed by the spring. Okay, both will be equal. That can be represented as what? Tau is equal to tau dash. Tau dash is the restoring torque developed on the spring, tau is the torque developed on the coil. So tau will be equal to tau dash at equilibrium. But tau, you know the formula, that is nothing but n bar sine theta, but here theta will be 90 degree. That can be obtained by the radial magnetic field. That will be equal to tau dash. Tau dash can be written as k into pi. Here, pi is the deflection produced by the pointer. K is a constant. Okay, da? K is a constant. That constant we can call it as galvanometric constant. Okay. So, INBA sin 90 is equal to k pi. Now, you can write I is equal to k pi divided by NBA. So, here the k and the NBA, everything is constant. Number of times we cannot be able to change once it's fixed. Magnetic field we cannot be able to change once it's fixed. Area of the coil cannot be changed once it's fixed. So, everything will be constant. So, the constant all can be removed by a proportionality symbol. So, I directly proportional to pi. That means the deflection produced in the pointer directly proportional to the current flowing through the given circuit. If more current flows, more deflection. If less current flows, less deflection. Okay, that can be obtained. This is the principle and construction and working of a moving coil galvanometer. Either you can draw this diagram or this diagram. This is given in your textbook. So, preferably you draw what are the first diagram than the second one. Second diagram once for your own understanding. Here, the hanging of the string not shown. It's look like what not a spiral. But actually, it is what not a hand. The other end only the coil will be connected. When the current flowing through the coil, it will experience a torque. It gets what not a twister. So, you can able to find out. So, this is the principle of what not a moving coil galvanometer. Okay. Thank you, students. I need one more class to complete the portion for magnetism. Okay. Thank you.